The Peasant and Bear solo from Stravinsky's ballet Petrushka is one of those excerpts that is often asked. The bear is being persuaded, rather reluctantly, to dance for spectators at a fair. The bear is clearly not in the mood, as is evidenced through its rather ponderous movements and bellows of discontent. Towards the end, the bear and his master move into the background as the scene slowly changes. This excerpt is often asked, and can offer a lot of chances for the tubist in creative interpretation. A few items worth noting. Although a bass tuba will give the tubist a lot of freedom from worry in the upper register than will a contrabass tuba, one should aim for the biggest, broadest, most bear-like sound available. Ironically, though, one of Stravinsky's own recordings of this ballet score seems to have used a tenor tuba, probably from an early tradition of having this piece played by the Ballet Russe in Paris, where the single C French tenor tuba was popular. Try to distinguish between the different types of accents that are printed in this solo, particularly evident in the third bar. That is a good place for the bear to bellow. The ponderousness of the bear can be shown in the last two bars of the excerpt with tentatively moving eighth notes, which, although not behind, are clearly not rushing ahead either. The slight crescendo at the end, which suddenly dies softly on a high D, is only printed in the earlier version of this ballet score. It should be noted that the printed differences between the 1911 and 1947 versions of this solo have never been an issue in regards to interpretation during performance. Only one note of caution: the bellow played in the third bar of the solo could throw an unimaginative conductor or audition committee for a loop. Perhaps a slightly restrained roar could be used until you have the job. The final 5/8 section, with the rapid eighth notes, is occasionally asked. The 1947 version is written in the lower octave.